it just really amazes me how people can just constantly keep roasting one another, all just because of stupidity, because they think that they shouldn't do a certain thing or play a certain thing or, you know, this and that. Like, it's just completely ridiculous. Let's get this video started, shall we? Easy go. So, the three best TVs that is sponsoring this video, for those of you that end up watching, these are the three best TVs that are at affordable price, and you still get amazing picture quality, and you're getting all of the next-gen gaming features that a PlayStation 5, an Xbox Series X, or Series S, or even an RTX 3000 series graphics cards. You're getting all of the features that those all take with each of the three of these TVs. And the three TVs that I highly recommend for your next-gen gaming experience, whether if it's on PC or the new consoles, is one, the Vizio P-Series Quantum, as you can see right here, and also the TCL 6 Series Mini Q LED 4K Ultra High Definition Smart Google TV, and the last but not least, the Sony X900H Series Television. So, these are the three best, highly recommend TVs that will still give you all of the next-gen gaming features and still maintain a wonderful picture quality, and also the best for, basically, for your buck for the pricing that they are. So, these are the three highly recommend TVs that I have for you for your next-gen console or PC gaming experience. So, welcome back to my channel, Infernal Shard 1 for the win. So, I have basically been a gamer for a really, really long time, and there has been some things that have came up over the last several of months, especially with the launch of the PlayStation 5 and the Xbox Series X, which are literally about to turn a year old and literally just a little over a week or two from now. And I have been getting so many freaking, like, people roasting me because of the fact that, like, I still basically game on those two platforms right there, which you can see are the PlayStation 4 Pro and the Xbox One X, and I still think that the consoles are really worth it, and they still are pretty decently when it comes to power, like I was making a video on just yesterday. And yeah, like, because I play those consoles, like, still, because there's, like, so many great games, I got external storage, you know, save data and this and that, and I can, like, store, like, almost, like, 100 to 200 games, because for both of those, I literally have a 4 terabyte external, and there still is not as many games out right now for the PS5 and Xbox Series X. We are getting there. I will say that now with the launch of Far Cry 6, Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart, and Call of Duty Vanguard that's coming out in literally just a week from today, and we're starting to get some games out, but there is still not a whole lot that is still out right now. And the reason why I still basically game on the last-gen systems, especially the Pro and the X, is because, well, for one, they're still extremely powerful, in my opinion. I'm still getting the 4K, the HDR10, the Dolby Vision, you know, like, all of those that those consoles support. Now, it may not be as high in frame rate like it would be on the PS5 and Xbox Series X, which I've actually started to play Far Cry 6 on my PS5, and it is freaking wonderful, and it's definitely hard. But I've had people literally roast me because of the fact that I still basically game on those two platforms, basically. Even now with the Xbox and PS5 that we've got, people just like to roast because they think it's so funny. They think that they're special, and they literally think that you should like you should only play what they think and not if you want to play it. And this is where stuff gets a little bit like ridiculous. And like, I understand that like you think that we should play on the best platforms possible. I get that. But when you think about it, like, in a different perspective, I mean, heck, there's still people out there that still, they probably got a PS5, and they're still playing on their PS2 or even PS3. Everybody loves games that play games, and there is so many great games on each individual platforms that people can still play, and especially with the online features that started with the PlayStation 3 and the Xbox 360 back in 2005 and 2006, there's still people that still love to play those older consoles. So, like, okay. So let's say somebody gets an Xbox Series X or even a Series S, but they still have an Xbox 360. And, like, let's say they're playing The Legend of Spyro, Dawn of the Dragon, which, if you want the best version possible, you can only get that game on the 360 or PS3, and let's say that's a game that they're playing, and that's definitely a game that is not backwards compatible on the Xbox One or even the Xbox Series consoles. And Dave was like, yeah, I just kind of want to play some an old school classic like Legend of Spyro, Dawn of the Dragon. That game, it was like the last major good Spyro game until now we got the Reignited Trilogy. But that game's not backwards compatible, like I stated, on either the Xbox One or the Xbox Series consoles. And so let's say like somebody just wants to play that game and they want to go revisit their memory. They got an Xbox Series X or a Series S, but they want to go back and play a game that they missed that was really good, that they missed from their childhood. And people are probably just going to roast the guy because of like, oh, bruh, you're seriously playing on a next gen or a last gen console, bruh. Bro, why the heck are you playing on that old piece of garbage? If you got a next-gen console, bro, why don't you play it on that? Like, nah. They don't get that not all games are backwards compatible on the Xbox One and Xbox Series consoles. And it's the same thing with the PlayStation 2. There's people that might even play the original version of Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, even though the trilogy has officially got confirmed from Rockstar, and it is coming out in literally just 2 weeks from now. But maybe they want to play the original version of Grand Theft Auto San Andreas that came out in 2004, and they got a PS4 or even a PS5, and they decide, well, I don't have nothing better to play. I might as well play an old school classic. Gamers can play whatever they want, and it's really ridiculous that people just like to go literally roast others and go after others just because they're not playing what they think that they should play, and they're playing what they want and some, you know, what they like from back in the day. It's really ridiculous. And I know we're getting ready to talk about restaurants, which we do not talk about that because this is a gaming channel. Okay, so as you can see on my shirt that I'm wearing, this is a McDonald's. This is a popular restaurant like worldwide across the whole earth. And this restaurant, I do not know if it's a worldwide like this restaurant is, but in my area, which I live in the US and I live in Ohio, and the restaurant that we have in this area that is like new and whatever, it might be not so new, it might be in around for a while and we may have just gotten it recently, but there's a restaurant called Texas Roadhouse, and it's more like newer feel than like what this restaurant is. This restaurant has been around for quite some time now, really like a really, really long time. So are you going to really roast somebody just because they decide to go to a McDonald's restaurant over a Texas Roadhouse, even though Texas Roadhouse is a new restaurant? Are you going to literally go after them because they want to go to that restaurant because they like it? Are you going to roast them? It shouldn't matter either way, because if they like that restaurant, then they can go to it. If they like the other restaurant, then they could go to it. Everybody is has different freaking feelings and different opinions about stuff and different, like, whatever. It doesn't matter if it's food related, gaming related, or vehicles related, or apartments or houses. It don't matter. That everybody likes different things, even if it's new or old. And I'm sick and tired of seeing people that like to roast others, including myself, that I have had it for this, like, past several months because of the fact that I like to still play on my PS4 Pro and my Xbox One X most of the time because there's just so many games out right now. I got plenty of storage, and games are still coming out, and I still got most of my friends that still have a last-gen console, and it just works out in the end because there's still games coming out. I still have majority of my friends are still on there, and plenty of storage compared to those two guys with only just, like, close to 1 terabyte. Well, I mean, we do got a 2 terabyte now with our Series X with our 1 terabyte expansion card added to. But even still then, that's still not, like, a completely ton of storage. You could hold, like, 30-some games, including, like, last-gen games, but if you was to do, like, only next-gen, you're probably roughly only going to hold, like, 10 games, maybe 15, but even that, there's not even that many games out right now for the next-gen systems at this point. There's roughly around, I want to say around 10 to maybe 11, so, yeah, it's ridiculous that people like to roast others just because they like to play old systems and not the new systems like they think that they should and this and that and blah, blah, blah. It's completely ridiculous. You play what you want. It doesn't matter if you play an Atari, a PlayStation 2, an Xbox 360, or even a PlayStation 4 or an Xbox One, and you got a Series X or Series S or PS5 or even PS5 All Digital Edition. It don't matter if you got the newest, best thing, and you still like to play something from an old platform or whatever. You can enjoy what you like. That's why you buy the games and you collect them, is to play them, and then someday in the future go back and revisit them, and if it brings back amazing memories and all that. Like just recently, I started to recently play, like, A Legend of Spyro, A New Beginning on my PS2, like, earlier in the year, and that's a game I don't care. That game came out in 2006, and The Legend of Spyro, A New Beginning is, like, one of my all-time favorite video games ever made. Amazing action, amazing adventure, amazing level design, amazing music, amazing story. Like, that game just absolutely is so freaking perfect, and it does not have any bugs. It plays out so smooth. It's one of the best video games ever made, and this game came out in 2006, literally almost 20 years ago, and this is still one of the best video games that I have literally ever played, and I still love it dear to my heart, still to this day. So, you play what you like. Do not give a crap of what people want, like, what people want to say about you, and if they want to roast you. You play what you like, even if you are playing on a PS5 and they're jealous because you got a PS5 and they still have a PS4, or if it's either the other way around, they got a PS5 and they think that you shouldn't play but your PS5, but instead you're playing, like, your Xbox 360, playing a game like I mentioned, The Legend of Spyro, Dawn of the Dragon. So, don't let people roast you for what you like. If you want to play old platforms compared to some of your friends that have new ones, or people that just want to roast you, I just wouldn't worry. But I will say it's kind of really ridiculous that just people just love to roast others because of the fact that they think that they only should play next gen, and they shouldn't be able to go back and play any of their old classics that they miss from their childhood. You know, it's completely ridiculous, and it just shows that you're the better person than what they are. So, yeah. This is Infernal Shard 1 for the win, signing out. Hope you all enjoyed the video. If you guys could, hit that like button and also subscribe if you are new, and be sure to turn on notifications so you will be notified with every new video we got coming up going forward. And also be sure to leave us a comment down below if you have gotten roasted from any of your friends, or just random people in the gaming community or whatever, because you still play on a PS4 or an Xbox 360, or even if it was like an Xbox 360 and the Xbox One was the newest console at the time, like 7 years ago. So yeah, just leave us a comment down in the comment section down below if you've got roasted by friends or even random gamers around the world. And hit that like button and subscribe, and we will see you guys on the next video. Peace. I walk around like that nigga.